Hello, myself S.K. Chaudhary, and I am today I am going to tell you about the single phase and three phase induction motors and various other motors which are used in dairy industry. Mostly we are using in the dairy industry. First of all, I will tell you what is the difference between the single phase and three phase induction motors. Okay, now you see the winding. This is the stator of a single phase induction motor, and this is the rotor of a induction motor, and this is a three phase induction motor, and this is the DC motor we are using. Okay, now what is the constructional difference between this three phase and induction motor? Now basically in induction motors, whether it is a three phase induction motor or it is a single phase induction motor, there is no basic difference between as far as construction is concerned. Now if the stator is say similar to for both the motors, whereas in rotor there is slightly difference. In a three phase induction motors, you see this is the rotor of a three phase induction motor and this is the rotor of a single phase induction motor. You see this is a squirrel cage rotor, the fans are there, this is the rotor part is there, these are the end rings are there, the similar end rings are here also. Okay, the bearings are there, the bearings are there, end rings are there, these are the end rings which are also there. In the difference is the only, you see this is a centrifugal switch. The centrifugal switch is used to insert the starting winding in the circuit when the motor we have to start off. Okay, whereas in this three phase induction motor there is no starting switch is there, or that is centrifugal switch is not there, because in a three phase induction motors the motor itself produced a starting torque. Whereas in case of single phase induction motors, the torque produced in an induction motor, single phase induction motor, is not a self-starting torque, but it's a rotating torque only. It's a magnitude is changing, but it's not a rotating one. So to make the motor self-start in a single phase induction motor, it's a big problem for us. So we have to make some changes in the induction motors, single phase induction motors. So this is the, we have in a single phase induction motor, we have two types of winding. Two windings are there. Number one is the running winding and second is the starting winding. As the name indicates, the running winding is used for the continuous run of the motor, whereas the starting winding is used only for the starting purpose, for the starting purpose. So, and when the motor picks up speed 80% of the rated speed, the centrifugal switch, the function of a centrifugal switch comes in picture, and it disconnect the starting winding from the circuit. And when it disconnect the starting winding is disconnected from the circuit, the motor will continue to run on the single phase winding only single winding. Okay, now when the motor is switched off and the speed is reduced to below the 80% of the rated speed, the starting winding comes in the circuit of the motor, comes in the circuit of the motor. So this is the function of a centrifugal switch, and a capacitor is also used to have a phase difference between the magnetic field produced by the starting winding as well as the running winding, so that we can be able to produce a rotating torque one, which is not present in if we are not using the starting winding. So depending upon the starting mechanism, different motors are available. If it is a capacitor start motor, so we can say it's a capacitor start induction run motor. If the capacitor is continuously remains in circuit, as in case of, you see this in ceiling fan, there is no centrifugal switch is there, but the circuit permanently remains in the circuit, so we can say this motor is the motor we are using in the centrifugal is ceiling fan as well as table fan. This is a capacitor start capacitor run motors. Okay. So depending upon the capacity, different rating of capacitors we are using here. Now, whereas in case of three phase induction motor, you see, if you see the picture carefully, you see the different poles are there. We can visually say that it's a four pole motor, 1, 2, 3, and 4. We can say these are the four pole motors, and four pole motor, depending upon the pole, number of pole, the speed of the motor is determined, because the speed of a motor is NS is equal to 120 F/P, where P is the number of pole and NS is the synchronous speed of the field. Okay, so this is a four pole motor, and if you calculate the speed, synchronous speed, that is 4 pole is there, 50 frequency is 50 cycle per second, the speed will be 1500 RPM. Okay. Now you see here in this, in case of 3-phase induction meter, we cannot easily view the number of poles. We cannot use only by the, if you know the number, total number of slots and the pitch of the winding, only then we can say that this is a, how much number of poles are there and what is the speed of the. But on the plate itself, you see this is a plate is there. On the every motor have a connection plate, data plate is there. On the data plate, the speed, number of poles and other informations are, number of phases are also there. The other connections are, other information is are, will be available on the connection plate. So you see, the, there are the 6 terminals are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 terminals are taking out. Whereas in case of single phase induction motor, we are having only 4 terminals are, we are having 4 terminals only. Whereas in case of 3-phase induction meter, we are having the 6 terminal. So the 6 terminals are there because we are having a 3 windings. Every winding has 2 terminals. So total number of terminals will be 6 terminals. And these 6 terminals are connected, this winding is connected either in star or in delta. When we connect the motor, winding in star or delta, in star the input voltage which is we are feeding to this motor, that is reduced to 58%. When the voltage is reduced, the current itself reduced to 58%. So the, our problem is that if the bigger capacity of the motor is directly connected to the supply, so it draws a very high starting current. That is a problem for us also and for the neighboring also, because the system voltage gets reduced. So to avoid that eventuality, we use the star delta starter. The star delta starters are further off. Two types, one is manual star delta starter and automatic star delta starters. We switch on the motor first in star to the downward position, then it is, when the motor picks up speed, same things is there. What we are doing by the centrifugal switch, that it's cut off the starting winding. When the motor picks up 80% of the rated speed, we switch over the motor to the delta, so that the full voltage is applied to the motor. When the full voltage we are applying to the motor, it will draw a full current as its capacity and it, the full torque will be produced. When we reduce the voltage, the torque produced also reduced. So this is a problem in case of star delta starters, that when we reduce the voltage to reduce the starting current, our starting torque also reduced. So that problem is overcome in case of slip ring starter motors. In a slip ring starter motor, the stator is fed to the already directly connected to the delta connection. But in the circuit of the rotor, we add the resistance. When we add the resistance in the starting, what happens? The starting torque is increased. So that is why this slip ring induction motors we are using in the our refrigeration systems, ammonia plants, for chilling the products. We are using the, because it requires a high starting torque. In ammonia plant, we from the starting, we require a high starting torque. So that is only possible in case of slip ring induction motor. That is why everywhere in the chilling plants or in the refrigeration plants, you will see that we are using the slip ring induction motors. And rest of the things are, you see, the parts are concerned. These are the end rings, okay? And this is the different cores, you see. If you see the core is there. The different slots are there. The slots are open type or semi-closed type. This is the semi-closed type slots are there. The similar slots are here also. The same slots will be in the stator. So this basically in stators, I will particularly say that in stators, there is no basic difference between the between a single phase and a 3-phase induction motor stator. As far as stator is concerned, the difference is that if we are inserting the, if we are winding the stator for a 3-phase induction motor, we are putting the three windings, that is a 3-phase induction motor. If you are winding it for a single phase induction motor, that is we are providing a single phase induction winding, that is a single phase motor. But the rotor is also almost the similar, only the in a 3-phase induction motor, the centrifugal switch we are seeing here, that is absent in case of 3-phase induction motor, because this 3-phase induction motors produces the, it is a self-starting motor, there is no starting problem here. Okay, now after that, there is, this is a cut model of a DC motor. In a DC motor, we are using DC motors also. in a DC motor, the armature is wound. The armature is wound here, and on the stator, the number of poles are there, different poles are there. Okay, so the DC motors, merely we are using in the dairy industry, we are not much, it is not in much use. So this is the, in a DC motor, the stator, this is the rotor, this is the end rings, these bearings are, arrangement is there. Of course, there is a bush arrangement is there. And you see there is a carbon bush arrangement is there to give the supply to the stators. Now the question is, what is a motor? What is a motor? The motor is a mechanism, motor is an instrument, which machine which can convert electrical energy into mechanical energy. This is a motor, means which can convert electrical energy into mechanical energy. We are feeding here, you see this is the connection plate is here. We are giving the electrical energy here and we are getting the mechanical energy as a output. We are giving the input as electrical energy here and we are getting the electrical mechanical power as a output. So this is a motor, this is a motor. Now the question arises, what is a induction motor? Why its name is as a induction motors? Now you see, when we insert this rotor in the stator have no physical contact with the rotor, with the stator. The rotor have no physical contact with the stators. You see, we are feeding the electrical energy, we are connecting the electrical energy to the stator only. There is no electrical contact between the stator and rotor. There is no electrical contact is there. You see, now how the energy is transferred to this? We are giving the electrical energy here and we are getting the electrical energy output here on the rotor, on the shaft of the motor. How it is possible? That is possible only due to induction. That is possible only due to induction. How it is, what is the induction we say? You see, when we connect, give the electrical supply this coil, these are the four coils, they are connected in series or series depending upon the different poles are there. Okay, so when we give the electric supply, it will produce four poles, NS, north and south, from the north and south, four poles are there. Okay, so the magnetic field will be formed here. Magnetic field will be formed here. Now this magnetic field, will link with the, you see, the squirrel cage, its full name is squirrel cage induction meter. Squirrel cage, what is the squirrel? You see, you know the, what is a squirrel? Squirrel is, there is a squirrel cage is there, on the body of the squirrel also, the cages are there. That's why its name is squirrel cage induction motor. You see, these are the cages. Now you see, the aluminum bars are inserted here. Aluminum bars are inserted here in all the slots. These are the different slots are there. Aluminum bars is inserted here and these aluminum bars are short circuited with these two end rings. With these two end rings, the aluminum bars are short circuited. Now the aluminum bars are short circuited here. Now it's a Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. It's a name of a scientist. Okay. What he says that when a short circuit coil is placed in a magnetic field, changing magnetic field, the EMF will induced in that coil. That is due to induction. That is due to induction because we are not having any electrical contact with the stator and we are transferring the power. So that's why its name is induction motor. This is a three-phase DOL starter, that is direct online starters. And the question arises, why we need starters? Okay. Now the starter is, as we know, the start, what start is there, that is used to run the motor. Now we can, without the starter, we can run this motor also with the main switch on direct only. But the starters plays an important role for the safe and smooth running of the induction motors or the, for the motors. This starter is, saves the motor from the overloading, single facing. Okay, and when we switch on the motor directly with the main switch, either of the three phase may be missing. So when there is a phase missing is there, that is known as a single facing is there, the motor may burn out. So this starters, or when the motor is in running position, the motor may have a single facing, one phase may be out of order. So the motor will continue to run on the two phases itself, and with the passage of time, with the because the motor will start drawing overcurrent from the two phases, so the motor may burn out. So to avoid that, the overload relays are there that will switch off the motor. That is, I will show you the different parts of the starters is there. this is overload relay. Okay, this is overload adjuster. We can adjust the setting of this pointer here. We can adjust according to the capacity of the motor. Okay, higher for higher capacity, we can increase the current rating. Okay, when I press this overseas, you see there is a movement in the downward also there, and this both of these two, there is a movement in there. When I press the switch, that will press this button. You see, when I press it, the motor starts working. You see, the motor starts working. Okay, when I press this off button, when I press this off button, the movement is there in the pressing. Okay, that will press this off switch. You see, there is a movement in the no volt coil. The plunger, when I press it, the plunger is moved upside. So when it moves upside, there is a with the help of these connection plates, you see, the three phase supply is given going to the motor, and when I press it, the plunger come back to the with the help of spring tension here. So this is a three phase dual starter, and this starter is used up to 5 HP. Now the up to now we have studied about the direct online starter. Now the question arises, why we need this starter, dual star delta starters? As we know that when the motor is started up in this ring, in the starting, it will draw 5 to 7 times current, higher current than the full load current. Okay, when the capacity of the motor increases, it will draws very high current, and due to when we draw heavy, very high current from the supply system, the system voltage gets reduced, and the simultaneously the in dairy industry we are having so number of instruments which are very sensitive to the voltage fluctuation, to the voltage that will get trips. So to avoid that, so we are using the DOL starters. When the capacity of the motor increase beyond 5 HP up to 15 HP, we are using this dual starter. Now the dual starter are further of two types, the manual dual starter and automatic dual starter. Now in a dual starters, we have three position. You see, this is a star position here. In the center it is O, that is O position, and it is delta position here, that is a delta, you see. Okay, when we press it into, now the sequence of operation is, first we start the motor in the star, so that the voltage connecting to this motor is reduced to 58%. When we reduce the voltage, the current run from the motor is from the starting. The starting will automatically reduce to 58%. So when the current is reduced to 58%, that will not hamper our system voltage. Okay. Now you see here the different parts. As in case of dual starter, this is your NVC coil. The overload relay is there, and current adjuster is there. Okay, now the missing is on off switches. In the previous case, there is a two switches are red and green button are there, but here only the off switch is there. The green button is completely missing, because in place of green button, we are having the handle, we are having the starting handle. So the first, you see, the main thing is, you see, here is a copper strip is there, which is short circuit the three winding of the motor, which short circuit the three winding of the motor to make the to connect the motor in the star, in the starting winding. Okay, this motor is having the six terminal. Okay, now the six terminal, three are the starting terminal and three are the finishing terminals. Now we can say that the A1, A2, A1, B1 and C1 are the starting terminal or finishing terminal, whatever notation we may take, and A2, B2 and C2 are the finishing terminals. Okay, now you see, these are the one starting terminal and one finishing terminal, and one starting terminal and one finishing terminal, one starting and one finishing terminal are connected here. Generally, this is A1, this is B2, B1, C2, this is C1, A2. In this fashion, these terminals are connected so that we can connect the motor in the star. After that, when the motor picks up 80% of the rated speed, we may connect to the delta position. Now I may start this motor in star position first. You see, the motor is running in star condition. Now I switch over to delta. Now the motor will remain in this, the motor will remain in the delta position, and it will continue to run. Now to switch off the motor, I press this button. I press this button, you see, this in the same fashion in the off switch in the dual starter. This knob will, when I press this knob, this knob will press this button, this strip. This strip will press and supply going to the no-volt coil is switch off, and the motor will be switch off, and the handle will come back in the off position. The handle will come back to the off position. So this is a working of a dual start, and this straddle starters.